So the question was, what motivated me to get into finance? Which is a great question. For me, for my personality, speaking from just my perspective, I found finance to be the place where I wanted to work. I found it to be a little more interesting personally. I found it to be more dynamic field. I find that accounting tends to be more the science, and finance tends to be more the art. So you kind of combine those in getting to investment world, from my perspective. However, I cannot emphasize enough the importance of the accounting background. That was the building block for everything, you know. There are people that study finance to get into finance, but I personally believe they miss out on the accounting element of it, which would give them a much better perspective on exactly what they're doing. Because the finance guys, no matter how sophisticated they are, they're taking the accountant's numbers and they're using them to make their projections. So if you know how the projections are made, you can be that much better of a finance person. I'm sorry, if you know how the original numbers are made, you can be that much better of a finance person. Because the accounting standards are one way today, they're going to change. So if you're in finance, you need to stay on top of that and be able to analyze it as an accountant to take the transactions apart and say, okay, what's really going on here? And from that perspective, I think accounting helps finance in a tremendous way. So for me, the transition was, to sum it up, was to go into something that I felt was a little bit more dynamic, where I could utilize my skills to a greater extent. And I felt there was a need to be filled in the market, because from what I saw, wealth management was limited to very wealthy individuals and those that already had a wealth advisor for many years. A lot of people who may not have millions of dollars were sort of left on their own to deal with commission-based salespeople and so forth. So there was also a need that I wanted to fulfill, and I had the confidence that I can fulfill that I could provide that service, fulfill that need, and help people in that respect. So that was another sort of transition that I wanted to make. Let me just say that having a CPA after my name is incredible, because people recognize that credential wherever you go, and then if you want to be able to make a name for yourself, you have to find the right credentials. I mean, in the financial industry, I don't know if people here have done a search, but there are hundreds of credentials that you can get. Many of them, you just take a quick multiple choice exam, you pay the fee, you got the credential. And it's not recognizable, they all look the same, it looks like alphabet soup. You know, people can't really tell them apart anymore. But people do know the CPA. You know, CFA, CPA, very recognizable. And I would definitely recommend everybody in here to go ahead and pursue that. If you need the credits, get the credits. If you need to take the exam, study for it, definitely do it. I mean, all the big four provide the courses for free. I know they provide Becker. I received Becker as well. I used a different course. Also, you know, you can mix and match whatever's more comfortable for you. And that's it. I would say definitely get the exam out of the way, because wherever I go now, I can say that I'm a CPA, and all of a sudden people know. People know they have a certain level of knowledge, a certain level of skill set that may be helpful in almost every field. So. Yeah. So, and another tip that I would throw out, if anybody's going into public accounting, is learn Excel. Be a master of Excel. The person next to you, you have to be better than them at Excel. Now, if you got to take classes, YouTube is a great source. Do whatever you can, because your value at a public accounting firm, a lot of it stems from your expertise in using that one program. I can't overemphasize it. If you get pivot tables, if you can take vast amounts of data, sometimes you get corrupted spreadsheets, nobody knows what to do. If you're that person that says, I got it, I'll take care of it, bam. You work it out, that's gonna give you a lot of points, and that's gonna really make you stand out. So whatever you can do to learn about Excel now, definitely do it. Because to learn on the job when it's 1 a.m, it's a bit tougher. So that's my recommendation. Definitely get the CPA. Definitely learn Excel as much as you can. And if you have any questions, let me know. All right, thanks.
One more.
PwC, they have separate departments
in
forensics.
Deloitte does.
They do.
I believe PwC does as well. I was in sort of the plain vanilla auditing group, so I didn't really get exposure to that a lot. But I know that a lot of these firms do. And that is a growing field from what I've read. It's very interesting to get into. Typically, when I was in school, I believe that auditing meant that you're looking for fraud. And a lot of people sort of have this assumption. I found out I was wrong, and I was very disappointed because I didn't feel like a detective anymore. So, from that respect, it's really an interesting field to get into. They have a credential certified fraud examiner or something like that. That might be something you might be interested in. But I don't think fraud is going to disappear. I think that we need to get smarter in finding it. And if you're looking towards that field, then you might want to see exactly how that works in with auditing, because you may be interested in something a little different. Because as auditors, technically, they don't look for fraud. It's usually found in other ways, not through the audit. So, any other questions? All right, thanks a lot. Appreciate it.